Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
All right, sure. This dance of mine might be getting a little old now, but who cares? Women telling women stories. Hey guys, my name is Sucharita. This is Film Companion. You're watching Not a Movie Review, and right now I am not going to be reviewing Little Women.
Least of all a woman. You'll need to marry well.
This is the story of the four March sisters, starting in Civil War America and ending shortly after. Desh jooj raha tha tab North versus South ki deadly battle se, and because most men were away fighting for the Union, the landscape, at least in this story, was excessively female. With the father away at war, it was up to the four sisters and their mother, Marmee, to figure out ki life mein ab aage kya karein paise kamane ke liye. And because this was the 1800s, jobs and careers weren't available to them to go interview for, so each of them had to figure out ways to live the kind of lives they wanted to live, despite only being little women. इस background में author Louisa May Alcott ने ये कहानी लिखी तो थी, लेकिन इसको कई बार तरह-तरह से adapt करके screen, stage, radio सब पर recreate किया जा चुका है. तो how to and why to take this story yet again for a film? ये challenge Greta Gerwig is faced with, and I can safely say that she succeeds in making this a fresh retelling. The first and most effective tool used here is the edit. Greta, who's also written the complicated yet easy to follow once you surrender to it screenplay, chooses to tell the story in a non-linear fashion. क्योंकि कहानी सबको पता है, कौन जिएगा, कौन मरेगा, कैसे डेथ होगी, ये भी सीक्रेट नहीं है if you're familiar with the novel. So to imbue the story with a relatable freshness, Greta goes where Jojo Rabbit went, but not with the slapstick humor without it. She makes it a point to show, sometimes subtly and sometimes not so subtly, how the United States till today and many parts of the world might still be mirroring the divisive, racist, sexist society which existed during the Civil War. Ek scene mein, when Marmee, in charo ki jo mother hai, is seen working at a service jahan people whose families are away at war, they get warm clothes and supplies. Yahan Marmee comments on how she's ashamed of her country, a sentiment we are hearing in varying degrees of emotion from many left-leaning Americans right now also. Also, this film, the resolve for women is center stage. It's a strongly feminist stand. Jahan book mein school khola jata hai for boys, idhar in the movie, the school is for boys and girls. Many characters which appear in the book have been entirely omitted because theirs isn't the story Greta Gerwig is interested in telling. One sister, Amy, makes a long and impressive speech admitting that yes, she has to marry for economics, but not because she's lazy and she lacks ambition, but because society doesn't give her the same opportunities as it does men to actually get rich. An argument one can make till date when people say the burden of financing a household is always on men, ignoring systemic gender-based oppression. Unlike many other adaptations, Greta Gerwig's lead character Joe is a mix of the character Louisa May Alcott wrote and Greta's version of it, where Joe also is Alcott, the eventual author of the novel Little Women. She's shown to be ambidextrous, just like Alcott was IRL. जो कि Little Women इसलिए publish होती है क्योंकि editor की बेटियों ने आधी कहानी पढ़कर पूरी कहानी की जिद करी, which is what happened to Alcott, not Joe in the books. She's both the girl in the novel and the writer of the novel, very effectively owning her story. I'd also like to believe, and maybe I'm reading too much into it, but Joe here is a little bit of Greta Gerwig also. You see her put together pages of her book, sliding them around, intermixing the way Greta has written the non-linear screen play, sliding and mixing scenes. जब न्यूयॉर्क में वही aforementioned editor ने जो को कहा कि जो भी नॉवल तुम लिखो, make sure कि उसके एंड में लड़की की शादी जरूर हो जाए. जो complies because उसके पास कोई दूसरा ऑप्शन नहीं है. She has to get published, but Greta has the option to revise that a little bit. And she ends the story not at the point where Joe is happily married, but devotes a long, elaborate close-ups में shot in your face sequence to show the process of a book being published, owning the copyright and finding love. Again, a nod to Alcott and her inspiring life. The story also reminds you that there isn't just one way to be a successful woman. Every individual sister has her own path, own flaws, and own successes. While Jo might be judging her sisters for not pursuing careers, the film never does. Emma Watson's character, a wonderfully poised and ladylike Meg, says to Jo, "Just because my dreams are different than yours, it doesn't mean they are unimportant." Amy, Jo ki ek aur behen, played by an excellent Florence Pugh, who probably has the most personality of them all, she takes you on multiple journeys with this character, literally and figuratively. Her relatable and fascinating internal journey featuring very prominently in the film. Towards the end, Amy, the least responsible of the lot, is the one who says to her sister Jo, maybe stories about women don't seem important because people don't write about them, pushing her sister to publish despite her jealousy at always having played second fiddle and never getting the kind of respect she craved. Essentially, her version of women telling women stories. Their mother, Marmee, while an angel descended from heaven, a part Laura Dern plays with a constant comforting smile, she confesses in a very soft moment when one of her daughters is deathly sick that she's nearly always angry. It's just one line, but it paints a whole picture of how she's had to lead her life suppressing her emotions, which is why she goes above and beyond to ensure that her daughters get to do exactly how they please. Saoirse Ronan goes off like a firecracker in many, many scenes, each time displaying a different side of her character, Jo. While she might be the most predictable of the lot, because 2020 chal raha hai, you kind of expect the lead heroine will have a certain character arc, it's Saoirse's performance which keeps you invested in the character. She almost doesn't feel like she belongs in the 1800s. She's loud, boisterous, tall, gangly, and more gender non-confirming than that time would have really let her be. Timothée Chalamet plays their wealthy neighbor, Laurie, in a very Chalamet manner. I'm not gonna lie. In an effort to give the character a sort of laziness which comes with being super rich, he begins to look like not having made too much of an effort really. Because if you see the original character Alcott wrote, he's got as many personalities within him as there are sisters, displaying a different Laurie to each of them. Something I felt missing here. At the heart of it, Little Women ek coming of age story to hai hi, lekin I think it's also an adventure story, like the Hardy Boys, but with girls. Yet it's adventurous, but it's still tender and soft, like Jo's hair flying in the wind at the beach. Even if you don't leave the theatre with the resolve of wanting to do something radical with your life, you'll still leave happy and satisfied with the storytelling, ready to go to bed and dream of cute, pretty things. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Little Women is 7th adaptation for the big screen. Lekin kahani phir bhi itni fresh, aap socho Louisa May Alcott was how ahead of her time. Ek scene mein na, Jo yells at a critic saying, "Itna aate tere ko to tu khud hi kyun nahi likh leta novel?" To which he calmly replies, "Kyunki wo talent mera nahi hai." Lekin the point at which the critic ends in the full story makes me think ki maybe this is a nod from Greta acknowledging that criticism is important. Or maybe I'm just being hopeful. Aap subscribe kar lo bas.